In part one of these energy balance for tubular reactors, we derive the equations. This is an example where we have two reactions, a molar flow rate, F, heat capacity, and this is molar heat capacity, derivative temperature respect to cumulative volume as we move down the reactor, and then heat of reaction for two reactions, and the heat transfer term. We could also write this in terms of a mass heat capacity and a mass flow rate, so density times a volumetric flow rate. So rho is density, small v is volumetric flow rate. And then we wrote down also mass balances, and then the term for this derivative that we derived also for the heat transfer term. So U is a heat transfer coefficient. This is the diameter of the tube. This is heat transfer coefficient. And so let's just look at a few other things that we might want to take into account. One is that the heat of reaction, which is at temperature T in this equation, in general can be a function of temperature. So at some reference temperature T0 and the integral of heat capacities from T0 to the temperature, the sum of the stoichiometric coefficients times the heat capacities integrated over temperature. So if we were looking at this first reaction, A goes to B, then this is just the heat capacity of B minus the heat capacity of A. But the stoichiometric coefficients, if they're products, it's positive, reactants is negative, and the number, of course, can be greater than 1 in general. We also might want to write this equation in terms of distance down the reactor. So Z is distance down or along the reactor. Instead of cumulative volume, V, then means we could replace the left side of the equation where we put the area, and now we can integrate and solve versus distance. We could also, for the mass balances, write them in terms of distance. So volumetric flow rate, concentration, this is the cross-sectional area, so AD is the pi D squared over 4 for a tube, and we could replace the volumetric flow rate with a velocity and a cross-sectional area. So the cross-sectional area drops out of the mass balance equation. But in general, U is a function of Z. So we cannot bring the velocity outside of the derivative. The other change that we might think about if we're solving these equations is to write the mass balance in terms of molar flow rate and weight of a catalyst, where now the rate expression has different units. So this is per weight of catalyst, and that's what determines how much reaction occurs in the catalytic reaction. And so we would in general have a series, derivative of temperature, say respect to volume or respect to Z, derivative of a cooling temperature respect to volume or Z, molar flow rate of A, and molar flow rate of B and C, and in general, the change in pressure with volume. So this means we should be able to write down, or we need to write down the equation for the cooling material. So the volumetric flow rate times the density of the coolant times the, in this case, a mass heat capacity. So this is for the coolant. We assume that we have some flow of coolant on the outside of the tube in a larger diameter, so annular region. The energy balance, change in the temperature of that coolant as a function of distance down, is pi du, the heat transfer coefficient, temperature to coolant, minus T. And we would solve this equation simultaneously with the other equations for a tubular reactor. And of course, in the general form of the equations, we can allow the heat capacities, the heat of reactions to change with temperature and the pressure down the reactor, and the velocity down the reactor to change. So this is a capital U here, just to make sure we're clear. This is the heat transfer coefficient. The lowercase u here is the velocity.